Good morning, students. As you know, today the revision video 3 will be given to you. Now, questions based upon different topics are to be discussed today, and you will have to write these questions, write the answers. If any bar chart or pictograph is there, you know that I have already informed you that you can either use the digital mode or you may use the pen and paper mode to draw them and then send them along with the questions and answers, so that your copy should contain all these things before they are being sent to the teacher for checking. Now we begin with the first question. In a page there are 25 lines and in each line there are 25 words. Find the total number of words in the book if there are 75 pages. So as you can see that, some of you may question this, how it can be possible. See that sums are sometimes given on some assumption. We have assumed that there are 12 words in each line and there are 25 lines in a page and there are 75 pages in the book. So you will have to find the total number of words in the book where there are 75 pages. Second question, observe the chart given below. As you can see that this is the chart for the number of cookies that the child or each child ate, and each of these figures stands for 3 cookies. So, as you know what you need to do, first of all you need to take the listing of all these things and then you proceed for other things. Now we have to find list name of each child and total number of cookies they had. So as I was discussing just a bit ago, that what you need to do, you need to just make out this thing that how many, which children had which number of cookies, and in the tabular form you must do that. Who ate more cookies and who ate less? There might be more than one name for each, might be, I said. So just take a look at that and then you start doing them. Find the total number of cookies the children had. Now let us move to the bar chart. So from here you can have a view from the question number A. You have listed it down. From there you can also find the total number of cookies that the children had. So for this question our discussion is over. Now we move to question number 3. Now there, as you can see, there are circles for each number, each of the children, and each circle stands for 2 years. So for example, for Gaurav you can see that it is 12 years, and for others I am not providing any kind of hint, so you can easily do them. Now while you are sending it, either the digital mode or the pen and paper mode, whichever you want to think, you may choose for making this pictograph. Now we come to the next page where there are questions. Question number A, list out the names of the children and the ages. Very easy thing and most important thing for such a pictograph. You have to list out the names of the children and their ages. Make a tabular form. On the left column, write down the name of the children, and on the right column, list out their ages. Now number B, who is eldest and youngest among them? I think from the pictograph you can get a vivid idea which child has greater age. That means who is younger and who is youngest and who is eldest among them. So you can easily find out. Now find the difference between in age of Gaurav and Ali. We come to the board again. See that this represents the age of Gaurav and this represents the age of Ali. So first of all you find out what is the particular age of Gaurav and what is the particular age of Ali, and then you do the subtraction. And the last question is find the sum of ages of the children. Now sum of ages of children means first of all you find the age of each particular children and just sum them up, that means add them up. So that will be done for your part. Now we come to question number 4. A man purchased a radio for ₹775, spent ₹125 on repairs and sold it for ₹925. Find his profit. So as you can see that first of all you have to find out or list out what is the total money spent on the radio. That will be the total CP, and the SP is given as 925. Then you find out the profit. And final question, question number 5. This is for a rectangle. The area of the rectangle is given to you. Its length is supplied to you. Now first of all you need to find out the breadth. You know the formula how to find out the breadth if area and rectangle are given to you. And then after finding that you find its perimeter. So that formula is also known to you. And as we have already discussed in the previous videos also, what you will do, you will just make the PDF along with the questions, the answers, the calculations, the pictograph, bar graph, wherever they are, and as per that you will send them to your class section teacher for checking whenever the video is being published. Thank you, students.